Hello, boys and girls. I have a really cute book here I think you'll love called The Caterpillar and the Polliwog. And it's by a man named Jack Kent. And I had been looking for a book in the library called Round Robin. I don't know if you've ever read that one before, but it's really cute too. And it's also by Jack Kent. And when we went to look up Jack Kent, we found this book. And I had never read this before, but it's really a cute and fun book. And I don't know if you've ever seen a polliwog before, but we're gonna find out more about him. I like the little handkerchief the caterpillar's got on her head. Okay, so let's find out. Caterpillars aren't like other folks, as ducks and hippopotamuses, and you and I get older, we get bigger. Especially hippopotamuses. But not caterpillars. They turn into butterflies. Aren't they beautiful? Turning into something else like that is not a thing just anybody can do. Down by the pond, there lived a caterpillar who was very proud of being different. She bragged about it to her friends. "When I grow up, I'm going to turn into something else," she told the snail. "That's nice," said the snail, who really didn't care one way or the other. "When I grow up, I'm going to turn into something else," she told the turtle. "I don't blame you," said the turtle, who didn't much like wiggly things. "When I grow up, I'm going to turn into something else," she told the polliwog. "What fun," said the polliwog. "What are you going to turn into?" Finally, she found someone who seems excited. But the caterpillar hurried on her way, looking for someone else to tell her secret to. "I wish I could turn into something else when I grow up," said the polliwog. "You will," said the fish. "All polliwogs do." "What am I going to turn into?" the polliwog asked. But the fish saw a tasty bug and dashed after it. "When I grow up," said the caterpillar who had circled the pond and was going around for the second time. "When I grow up," she told the polliwog again, "I'm going to turn into something else." "So am I," said the polliwog. "You?" The caterpillar was so surprised that she almost fell into the pond. "The fish said so," the polliwog told her, "and fish know things. They go to school." Fish have schools. The caterpillar was upset. "I thought only caterpillars could do it," she said rather sadly. "But what are we going to turn into?" the polliwog asked. "Well, I am going to turn into a butterfly," said the caterpillar. "Then I guess I will too," said the polliwog happily. "What fun! Let's do it together." "All right," the caterpillar agreed, although she would rather have done it alone. "But I get to go first." The polliwog didn't mind. He wasn't at all sure how it was done. "I'll watch you," he said. So when the time came, the caterpillar started to spin a cocoon. "This is the tricky part," she said. Here she goes, winding herself up. The polliwog watched as the caterpillar spun. Soon only her head was uncovered. "Now I have to close the lid," she said, "and when I come out, I'll be a butterfly." "Go ahead," the polliwog said excitedly. "I want to see you do it." "It will take a while," the caterpillar warned. She started spinning again and was soon out of sight in the cocoon. It does take a while. For a long time, nothing happened, but the polliwog was patient. He watched and watched and watched. For days and days and days. Do you see something is happening to him? Do you notice that? What's happening? little tail is shrinking, isn't it? At last there was activity in the cocoon. The end of it opened, and very slowly the caterpillar climbed out. Only she wasn't a caterpillar anymore. She was a butterfly, a beautiful yellow butterfly. She does look different, and he does too. The Polliwog was so excited, he hopped up and down with delight. He hopped up and down like a frog. "I was so busy watching you," he said, "I didn't notice what was happening to me." "You're a very handsome frog," the butterfly said as she flew off to try her new wings. And she's a pretty butterfly, isn't she? The frog was puzzled. "I thought I was going to be a butterfly," he said. A caterpillar wiggled by. "When I grow up," he said proudly to the frog, "I'm going to turn into something else." But the frog wasn't listening. He is looking at himself. He was admiring his reflection in the water. "I am, you know, a very handsome frog," he said. So he was happy to be a frog. Isn't that cute? You're growing too. And today, you might be little, but you are growing every day, and you're going to turn into something great. You're something great right now, but you have a lot to look forward to. Thank you for listening.